and greeting everybody who is hearing my voice and you who is watching me. My name is Pastor Emmanuel God's Power. I am from Ebonyi State, eastern part of Nigeria. I want to use this opportunity to confess how Satan used me and the other ministers of God this time around. In the year 1997, I started my business. I was doing well in my business. After some years, things started going wrong. I met one of my friends and told him my problem, and he took me to one prayer ministry. There, the prophet told me that I have call, that I should join them in that their ministry. My spirit did not accept that. I went back to my business. Things get worse more than before. I don't have any option than to join them in their ministry. I later joined the ministry. I worked with them so many years. Later, I found out what my master is doing and the source of his power. I decided to open my own ministry. I went to my master to tell him that I want to open my own ministry. When I told him that, he got angry with me, seriously. He started fighting me in all ways. When all these things is happening, I went and opened my own. But things is not easy for me. I am going from house to house to pray for people, market to market to preach the gospel. I receive help from the people I pray for. Then I open my own ministry in one warehouse. The name of my ministry is Jesus the Ark of Love Ministry, from the direction of the Holy Spirit. The hand of God is upon my ministry, but from the eyes of man, things were not moving well for me. Despite all the trouble and attack from my master, one day my master came to my house and swear that he will not be alive and see my ministry moving forward or stand. That is when I started looking for help here and there. I met one of my friends and told him what my master said to me. And he told me that my master cannot do anything to me if I will believe what he will tell me. And I asked him, "What is that? Do you want to tell me that I will believe?" He now asked me to come to one of his night vigil. When I read the night vigil, I saw miracles happen. In my eyes, I saw one boy vomit python. The whole thing was a surprise to me because I know him very well. That he cannot pray, even to fast. He don't know how to preach. Then I started asking myself, where is this power from? How manage my friend did all this miracle? Early in the morning, after the night vigil, I went to his office and asked him, "My friend, where is all this power from?" And he started laughing at me. He told me one thing that I will never forget. He said, "If you cannot beat them, you join them." That is what he told me that fateful morning. Then I started asking myself, what is the meaning of this? I went to him time to time, but he did not give me any answer, or rather to tell me his secret. I called his phone, but he did not give me any answer. One day, I decided to go to his office. Unfortunately to me, I met him, and I talked to him man to man. I pleaded with him to help me because I don't have any other thing to do. And he laughed at me and asked me, "Am I ready to become a man now?" I said yes, and he told me before he will tell me anything, I have to decide on myself and go into covenant with him. I go back to my house and think about that. One day, I said to myself, since he's doing all these things in the name of Jesus, I will go back to him. I went back to him and told him that I have agreed to do whatever he said. And he shook me and told me, now I am a man. He brought out one book, which I don't know what they write on it. We took oath with the book. Now, we agree between ourselves that whatever he's going to tell me, nor show me, that I will not discuss it with anybody. If I do, I will die or run mad. He told me to go back and get myself prepared, that we are going on a journey as a man. He said that when we come back from that journey, that I will be complete as a man and start seeing like other prophets. When the journey started, the first place we went to is Calabar. When we reached to Calabar, they killed dog and put the blood inside my eye, and I bathed with the blood of the dog. From that Calabar, we went to Ijabode, where I swallowed 7 eggs. That is why whatever I said with my mouth, people will accept it and do it. From that Ijabode, we went to where they call temple in Lagos. In that temple, they told me to remove all my cloth, which I did. They gave me red cloth to wear in order to be in uniform with them. They did all incantation and invocation. After that, they stand me before the mirror. In that mirror, I saw myself half and half. Then I asked my friend, what is the meaning of this? And my friend told me, now I am half of human being and half of spirit. And they told me to say whatever I want to be happening in my ministry to that mirror. Then I started saying it. After all said and done, one ring came out from that mirror. And they told me to wear it on my left hand finger, which I did. And they told me that it's only me and members of this temple can see this ring whenever I wear it. They told me that I would sleep in Babbage that night to know whether the things they did on my head work or not. I sleep in Babbage that night and get up the next morning and saw myself in hotel room in Benin City. I was surprised. I saw many pastors in that room, which I know them very well, together with that my friend holding my bag. I was so surprised, and they welcomed me and start shaking my hand one by one. They told me to sit down. As I get seated, they point at one box and ask me to go and bring the box, which I did. They asked me to open the box. I opened the box and I saw what they wrote on paper inside that box, that I should hurry up and get married. After the marriage, my wife will get pregnant. During the time of her delivering, she will die with the baby. They also give me a book that teach how to do invocation, miracle, and how to send attack to somebody and the other things. The book also showed me how to use miracle oil and where to get it. There, I noticed that book was the book I used to enter into covenant with my friend. When I came back from that journey, I stayed indoors for 7 days without seeing anybody, man or woman. After that 7 days, they told me to hold a crusade to show the power I received. I do that crusade. The first day of that crusade, people did not come out as I expected. But I performed many miracles that day. One of the miracles I did that day, in that crusade ground, I saw one girl. I called the girl out and told her she has been suffering from poison so many years and she has gone many places without solution. There, I asked her to go and bring one sachet of pure water, which she did. I collect that pure water from her with that hand I wear ring and raise it up and do some incantation, and I evoke something inside that pure water and pour that pure water on her mouth. And she vomit cowries, lizard, and some other things. I called another woman out and told her that you have been looking for a child. You have gone many places because of this problem. There, I told her that her problem is fibroid. I raised up that my hand where I wear that ring and hit her on her stomach. I called one of my workers to take her out where she will shed that fibroid. She went out and shed that fibroid with one egg. When they carried it out on that crusade ground, people started shouting. But that is not fibroid, is what I evoke in her body. That day, people gave me a lot of gifts that day. One man gave me one Camry car. The other one paid for my house rent. That woman with fibroid and her husband said they would change my wardrobe, which they did. Bags of rice and yam full everywhere. The remaining day of the crusade, people full everywhere. One man gave us land where we will build our ministry. This is how I started my ministry. The first thing I did in that my ministry, I called some of pastors from that our society. We took ram and go to my ministry one night and buried it alive in my altar. And also, we buried pigeon, salt, and sugar in the entrance of that my ministry. The purpose of burying that ram in my altar is to make people come to my ministry so that my ministry will be going forward. Why the work of pigeon, sugar, and the salt is to make people, whenever they enter my ministry, they will not go out again. And again, I sprinkle many types of oil in that my ministry compound. Particularly, the ones I spray in toilet and bathroom is to make people, whenever you use yourself there, you will collect one disease or the other. They will brought you back and I will cure you. My brethren, that is how I continue my life, full of evil. After they helped me bury everything that I need to be buried in my ministry, they told me that only thing remaining is for me to rush and get married as the Lord demanded. In a short period of time, I got married with one beautiful lady. Brethren, nothing good comes easy. If devil give you something with right hand, he will collect it back with left hand. When my wife gets pregnant, when she's about to deliver, I call my mother-in-law to come and stay with my wife because I know what is going to happen on the day of her delivering. One morning, I called my mother-in-law and my wife and told them that the Lord sent me to mountain to go and pray. They believed me, and wife told me to pray for her when I reached the mountain. 6 days after, my wife was in labor and they took her to the hospital to deliver. During delivery, my wife died in the hospital with my baby. Now, when the message reached me and my members, we are rejoicing and start shaking hands. And they told me, now I'm a man and my ministry will start going forward and doing well. They helped me bury my wife. On that burial, many prominent people come. Many people come from all walks of life. After the burial, my ministry started going forward. I have branches at Aba, Port Harcourt, Warri, Lagos, and Abuja, and the Benin. It's true that my ministry is moving forward now, but Emmanuel God's power is no longer Emmanuel God's power. Another spirit lives in me now. I call Jesus, but Jesus don't know me. I don't know him. Brethren, listen and hear how me and the other pastors are working with Satan and calling the name of Jesus. I have workers who are working under me. They are hoping that one day they will have their own ministry without knowing that they have collected their destiny. I am using my ring and oil to perform all sorts of miracles. But one thing about those miracles is that they don't last. I used to call many ladies in my ministry to anoint them for them to get married. They don't know that anointing oil that I use on them is for them to go out. If any man talk with them, the man will follow them back to my ministry, and I will collect the whole money the man came with. After, those men will not marry them, because those girls is what I'm using to get money from men. I'm doing the same thing with men in my ministry. I used to call them out to anoint their hands. That is how I collect their destiny. Whatever good that will come on their way will come to me. In every 3 months, I used to release blessing to some of them so that the others will believe that one day their own will come to them. They don't know that I am the God that giving them the blessing. Another evil work I did in my ministry is this. I used to tell some of the girls in my ministry to go and get the pictures of their boyfriend and somebody that promised to marry them. When they bring those pictures, I would do some incantation on it and buy them together. Even some boys in my ministry who are looking for rich lady to marry, I will tell them to go and bring their pictures. If they bring their pictures, I will buy them together. They will become husband and wife. But my brethren, you know that every gift that comes from Satan will not last. Small time, problem will come into those marriages. They will scatter. My brother, my sister, do you know what brought problem into your marriage that make you to divorce? Another people that is suffering very much in the hands of we call pastor, prophet, and minister is those men that are looking for fruit of womb. Sometimes we take them to water and naked them there and bathe them. Sometimes I make love with them. In many families, I have children. Sometimes some men doesn't allow me to come closer to their wife. That is why I mix oil with urine and water and give them in the name of holy water. So whenever the man hear my name in his family, he will give me chance to come into his family and do whatever I like with his wife. Then he becomes zombie in his family. I used to sleep with many women. I have hotel room in Asaba, Port Harcourt, Lagos, and Warri. The worst thing is that whenever a beautiful lady came to my ministry, I would told her that Holy Spirit said I will have special prayer with her. I would take her to my hotel room and make love to her and close her womb and also tie the destiny of any man that make love to her. Me and my fellow pastors has closed womb of so many ladies in so many cities, especially students who are schooling at Owerri, Port Harcourt, Lagos, even Abraka. Another one is what they call Power Night or Holy Ghost Night, but I call it Devilish Night because Holy Ghost don't know us. That night, we bring out all sort of evil power and use them to work. That night, I used to rub something on my face. When I enter my ministry, I will start telling them their problem, calling their phone number, even where they're coming from, I will tell them. even their family in them, and the problem they have in their compound. People will be clapping for me, calling me all sorts of names. All these things I'm doing without solution is just to collect their money. Sometimes, I will take pure water and raise it up and do some incantation on it and pour it on somebody's head. Something like zobo will be coming out from that person's head. Then I will tell the person that the black thing that is coming out from your head is the bad thing that follows you around. But it's lie, it's not true. It's work of that ring that I'm wearing on my hand. Sometimes I will call somebody out and prophesize on that person. And I will tell him that there is a spiritual chain that is holding him in the realm of spirit. And I will do some incantation and pull out the chain live. People will be clapping for me and call me all sorts of names. But that thing is not chain at all. It's work of that ring I'm wearing on my finger. The more you look, the less you see. Sometimes, many rich men are coming to me because of what they're hearing about me. Whether it's truth, because of one problem or the other, I will give them all sorts of prophecies, the bad one and good ones. Immediately they go, I will use their name, do incantation and invocation to make that prophecy come to pass in their life. As soon as it happens, they will run back to me to find solution to that problem. That is how I hold them captive and use their life to play. My brethren, listen very carefully and hear this one now. Many things are happening in so many markets today. In some line, many things are happening, but the people that is in that line don't know what is happening. But this one is the one that gives me money most. Many businessmen do come to me to know what it will take them to make their business move forward. Sometimes I will send some of them to go and bring sand from their shop. I will do some incantation on that sand, whether good or bad. They must sell their goods. Another one is the one I do with the rubber band. I used to do incantation with that rubber band and give it to my agents. They will go and pour it inside markets. Any sales girl or sales boy or oga that pick that rubber band to tie money, the money will be shorting. When that money short, oga will be accusing sales boy or sales girl. Oga will be asking himself, how do I use this money? Sometimes I do go to their shop to do prayer for them. After that prayer, I will give them oil and give them instruction how to use that oil. I will tell them to pour that oil inside their shop and put it inside water and pour it outside the shop. In this case, security people are seeing many things. In the night, people will start selling market inside that shop. When the security people want to find out what is happening in that shop, they will not see anybody in that shop. Early in the morning, the people that has those shops, they will be carrying huge of money to the bank. People will be surprised how managed, because there is no goods in their shops. Those people I pray for in the market, they will be doing fine, more than importers. But the whole money will be sharing 50-50 between us. But there is another thing we are doing in our societies. We are welcoming some businessmen. Those people, we are taking their fingernails, their hair, to the temple to know whether they made it to be our member. So those people, we give them 40 million naira each to do whatever business they like. But there's something about this money. If you use this money to build their house, first money you collected from tenant, you will bring it back to the temple. When you bring this money back to the temple, the whole tenant that is living in that house is now in bondage. People that live in those houses will be experiencing shit on the step in order to bring bad luck to the people that live in that house. And moreover, those are members that build those houses, they don't live in those houses. Another one is that those that are using this money for business, whenever you exchange business with them, your business will go down and the whole money will come back to our temple. Sometimes, if you are coming inside street, let's say 12-1-2 o'clock, you will see where goats gather. Two or three goats will be in the middle. That is where we are doing meeting with all the landlord of that street to know how to control the area. In many cities in Nigeria, you will see this kind thing. But one day, something happened. I prepared from my house to go to our meeting. On the road, I saw one trailer parked. I don't know that trailer spoiled, that a Abokiman was inside the trailer. When I want to turn to goat, a Abokiman started shouting, "Wanna, I not be goat. Wanna, I not be goat. Na human being so, na human being so." When I hear his voice, I ran inside bush. I went away. And another thing is that I have some agent which their work is to go out there and collect baby used pampers for me. Another thing is that all the sanitary pad that women use when they are on their menstruation, those my agent will bring them to me. Another thing is that I send them to public toilets to collect all the tissue paper that people use there. My brother, my sister, I want to give you one advice before I continue. Whenever your baby uses pampers or women use pad on your menstruation, before you throw it out, make sure you put kerosene on it or crude oil before you throw it out. Now listen, you that is watching me or you that are listening to me now, let me tell you the last thing that put me in this condition I am now. One thing I want to tell you now is about family liberation. Sometimes prophet will go to a family for family liberation. They will uproot many types of charms like chain, tortoise, bad lucky, cross, and chicken pass. And some will dig ground and ask you to pour water on it. After, they will put their hand and brought out one thing or the other. Now, listen to me. Let me explain how we are doing it. Sometimes, people will meet prophets that they want him to come and do family liberation in their family. Sometimes, the prophet will charge them 20,000 naira. Some will charge 100,000 naira upwards. After, he will use some of that money to buy something that we use for that family liberation. If a prophet wants to uproot chain in your compound, he will use part of that money to go and buy chain and put it in his magic box. If he wants to use tortoise, he will go and buy tortoise and put to his magic box. Whatever he wants to uproot in your compound, he will use part of that money to go and buy it and put it in that magic box. After, he will do all kinds of incantation on it and leave the box open before going to the family. When he reach that compound, they will start praying, singing, clapping their hands, and the prophet will start doing all kinds of incantation in the name of speaking in tongues. He will start calling people, bring shovel, bring cutlass, bring hoe. He's running up and down. Look at it here, look at it there. Then people will be watching him to know what he wants to do next. Then he will point his hand on the ground. If he wants to bring out tortoise from that ground, he will point his hand, tortoise will enter that ground. Then he will be calling people, come, they bury something here, they bury something here. Look at it, he's smoking here, he's smoking there. As he was pointing his hand, that is when that thing he put inside his body box will enter that ground. And he will give mark and tell people, I have pinned it. Come, let's dig it out. And so we dig ground and ask people to pour water inside it. After, they will put their hand and brought one thing or the other. Who put that thing there is him. I went for a family deliverance in many villages in this Nigeria. Now, listen to me, my brothers and my sisters. Let me tell you the last family liberation I went that put me into this problem I am now. First, let me tell you, I can't believe that hot water can kill tortoise, because every day is for thief, but one day is for the owner. But first of all, I want to give advice to every parent that is listening to me now. Every parent should understand the type of talent God gives to their children. Let them not play with it, but let them help those children to work with the talent. My people, I have been going before and coming in peacefully until I went for a family liberation in one family in Imo State. There, my eyes see my ear. I came down family liberation like before, and I thought that I would walk like before, without knowing that God had prepared three children to use them to open my nyash, and again, to use them to stop all bad work that I'm doing. I prepared myself like I used to prepare before, me and my prayer warriors, because the family is a very big family. I put so many things in my magic box, hoping that when I reach there, if I bring it out, people will start clapping for me, like so many places that I went. As we entered that compound, I saw men and women and children that are waiting for us. They welcomed us very well and give us where we will stay for a little while before our prayer started. As we are there waiting for the time, one of the children ran to his father and called his father, "Daddy, daddy, this pastor has seven heads." When I heard this very word, I was shocked because I don't know that I had seven hairs. But the father of this girl shunned her and told her to go and greet pastor. When that girl came to greet me, I used that hand that I wear ring to greet her in order to close her mouth. Immediately I hold her, fire came out from her body and burned my hand. There, I discovered that the family I enter, chance no deal. Because of that, I give instruction to lock all the children inside the house before we start our prayer. They did as I said immediately. When we start that prayer, I told my prayer warriors to continue praying. While I myself, I went further, sending an attack to those children. Because I want to close their mouth, for them not to say whatever their eyes are seeing. But when I was doing this, that girl that poured fire on me came out from the house and started calling her father again. Daddy, daddy, this pastor want to kill me inside the house. Then I give order to padlock all the children inside the house because there is demon in them that don't want us to do this prayer. When I'm still saying this, another child ran out of the house and start calling daddy, daddy. True, this man has seven heads. Don't you people see it? Then I shouted with a loud voice, binding and casting, like said there is a demon in those children. Whereas I am the one carrying the demon. And they take those children inside the house and lock them with key. But those children continue praying inside that room. Immediately I raise up my hand to invoke that thing that is in my magic box to enter into that compound. Immediately I raise up my hand, fire came down from heaven and flashed my hand. I bring down my hand immediately. I thought it was a joke and I raise up my hand again. Fire from heaven flashed my eye and my eye started scratching me and nobody noticed what I am passing through there. Because of that, I cut that prayer very short and give them prayer to do and promise them that I will come back next time. When we are going, my prayer warrior started asking me why I cut that prayer very short. And I told them that there are many demons in that compound that Holy Ghost told me to stop and come back another time. When we are on the road going back, that my eyes started scratching me seriously. And all my right hand started burning me down to my leg. I never encountered this kind of a thing since I started ministry. And I don't understand it. When I reach my house, I do all sorts of incantation to kill those children. When I sent that thing, what I sent came back to me and hit me down. I didn't see that my ring again. Magic box and that my book and all those things that I used to do invocation with, all of them miss. After that small time, I became blind and paralyzed. Then one voice told me, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. That is how I became blind and paralyzed till today. I called those my members, but they did not answer me. But one thing that surprised me is that I don't know how their numbers lost from my phone. Then I know that death is on my way. But that same spirit keep on telling me to go and confess all my atrocities. But I lock my heart against this voice. I have been in this sickness going to 7 months now. And I said I should come and confess all my sins and atrocities which I committed to the world. Hell! Hell! Greediness is not good. Bad thing is not good. See what I have caused to myself now. Please, my brothers and my sisters, listen to what I'm about to tell you now. If you are a pastor or a minister or a prophet or God called you to come and work for Him, don't try to help God, but allow God to use you. You pastors, evangelists, prophets, and all the ministers that open ministry and doing one crusade or the other, ask yourself whether you're working for God or you're working for money, or you are doing this in order to mislead people. Or you are listening to me, you that think that God give you one talent or the other to be a pastor or evangelist or a prophet, immediately you notice this gift in you. You become proud, feeling pompous and self-righteousness, and refuse to be obedient to the people that senior you. Because of that, you went and start opening ministry, churches that has no foundation, and say that it's God that sent you. Remember that God is not author of confusion, that His prayer is for us to become one. Now listen, you that they are doing family deliberation in your compound, God is not a magician. God has time for everything. You that are coming to do family liberation in your compound, remember that every worker has a tools. They are coming to work for you, not to pray for you. This work, they are working for you. Whether they are working on your body or in your family, this is the type of work I work with my magic boss before. Remember, anything they call charm that they buried in the ground will get rotten one day. Know it today that anybody that comes in your compound, dig out key, tortoise, and foul leg, know it that he played you while you. He collected your money just like that. Please, my people, I will stop here because what my eyes are seeing is too much. I will be with you next time. That time, I will tell you the name of other pastors that are doing those things with me before. They are still parading now. Thank you and goodbye.
As I am without one plea, God died that blood was shed for me, and thou that bidest me come to a land of God,
Precious Father, we thank you for a moment like this. For we know that it is not your will that anyone should perish, but all should come to repentance. May, O Lord, our hearts be fixed on you. Even as we listen to this confession, may it bring repentance to as many as are ready to listen to it and turn away from their evil ways. Thank you, precious and everlasting Father, in Jesus' name. Before this confession comes up, We have been told in the Bible, precisely in 2 Timothy chapter 3, from verse 1 through 4, that in the last days, men shall be lovers of themselves, having itching ears just to hear what suits them. As you stay focused right now, just listening attentively to our brother, Brother Emmanuel God's Power, who will be sharing with us his past experiences. But before that, could you please give us a nice song to serve as an introduction to this wonderful confession?
I want to thank God for keeping me alive today, because the enemy planned evil against me. If not by the grace of God, I would have been a dead person by now. But thank God for His mercies in my life, because if not for His mercies, those who call themselves pastors, but they are doing evil in the name of God, they would have killed me. I thank God so much for my life today. I want to also thank those who have been praying for me, and also some men of God who have been praying for me over the phone. I want to use this opportunity to apologize to those who wanted to see me in person, and those who want me to come to their church. It's not that I don't want to see you or come to your church, but for security purpose, I can't make it. Formerly, I was against those selling this confession in the market. But when I realized the importance and necessity of selling it to the market, I was forced to understand the reason why it was sold. That is why I'm sending my regards to Jesus Own Music Production for his effort to make sure that this message gets to many places in the whole Nigeria, because our members are all over the place in this country and beyond. My gratitude goes to my producer and those who made this confession possible. When I did the first edition of this confession, my intention was not that it will be sold, but due to pressure from the people who were eager to hear the whole episode of this confession, that is why I have no other option than to allow them to sell it, so that the confession will be an eye-opener to the people. As I'm talking now, there are still thousands of those who call themselves pastors who are confusing people with those fake miracles. This is the second edition of this confession. I promise you that if God keeps me alive today, I will tell you the name of pastors who are evil and their church names. First, pastors or prophets who are acting like magicians or native doctor who is removing physical thing from somebody's body. Such miracle is not from God. Whenever you see a pastor or a prophet selling herbal medicine to the congregation, such pastor is not from God. Now, let me tell you how to know them. They have very large congregation following them about. Not because of the word of God or salvation, but because of those magical things they perform. Now, let me tell you, in my former court, we had many pastors there, and every one of them was working according to his level or his commitment to the court. Some are homosexual, some are using human beings for sacrifice. What you give to the court determines your level in the society. Those that are homosexuals will be using their junior pastor or boys in the church. They are doing this to collect their destinies and reactivate their secret court altars. In my former court, we have branches in Ghana, Algeria, South Africa, and beyond. We also have many pastors and businessmen in our court, which I will tell you their names and their church names now. After the first confession I made, the same people that initiated me in the court have meeting against me. They gathered themselves in one hotel in Asaba. They planned all sort of evil against me and even about to kill me. They sent hired assassin to me. But as God may have it, they couldn't kill me. In that meeting, one of them brought out 1 million naira from his own pocket. Others brought their own too. They gathered all this money in order to frustrate me and kill me. But God showed them that He is God. Even the same boys to burn down my house in the village. My brother went to one of them to ask him why they did so. They locked him up in police cell. That is why I am out for them now. I will call their names, not only their names, but I will show the world their pictures. I know many of them want me dead, but before I die, I will expose them. My brethren, I want you to ask John Mensah of Messiah the King Ministry, Ghana, what I did to him. They have destroyed my ministry and my house won't dare leave me alone. I am blind now just because of them. I don't have anything left, but I know that what I have now is more than good. Christ in me is my hope of glory. I will not stop here without calling their names. First person is the man who can make anything possible to have your soul. His name is Pastor Johnson Gide of Power of Rhema Church, Calabar. Another one is Pastor Gio Osondo of Army of God Assemblies, Onitsha. Pastor Musa Milade of Yeshua the Great Church, Lagos. Evangelist Paul Wasi of Salvation Temple Ministry. This man is the man who can do anything. This man handed 7 babies in a mortar before the sun and also used their placenta to work for people. Only God can tell where he brought these babies. Another person is the most wicked man and the most occultic man on earth. He's a homosexual and money launderer. This man can do anything as far as money is concerned. His name is Prophet Emmanuel Kunle of Embassy of Jehovah Church, Warri. Another person is Prophet Michael Ebuza of Church of Zion Healing Ministry, Port Harcourt. His power is from Marine Kingdom. He loves music so much. He dances every time. When he dances, miracles start happening. But those miracles are now from God. Another church is most powerful church in this Nigeria. Oluwa Intervention Worldwide. This church supposed not to exist at all. This man does all sort of evil. This man uses virginity of young girls to activate his power. In his church, he sleeps with female choir members and even sleeps with married women who are members of the church. This ministry is demonic. There are so many of such churches and ministries around the world, especially in Africa. In countries like Nigeria, Ghana, South Africa, and other African countries. These are the names of people who call themselves men of God, but they are doing evil in the name of God. These are the people who cannot preach the word of God to the people, but they deceive people with their magic in the name of miracle. When you have problem and go to their church, you will go back with another problem. One day, somebody called me for a program. The person is just a beginner in the ministry. He went and arranged with one woman to come and act like somebody that had pipe rod in her womb. After that program, the woman came for her balance, and my friend told her that there's no money now. She should come after. The woman started shouting. That is how I noticed what was going on. When I want to settle the quarrel between two of them, another boy came and started asking him for his former balance. When I asked the boy his problem, the boy told me that in his last program, the pastor told him to act like deaf and dumb person. My brethren, is this not an arrangement miracle? When I called out my friend, the pastor, to ask him why, he told me that that is how he has been doing it all this while, and people are believing him that he's a strong pastor. He has been doing miracle. My brethren, that is what you are seeing in the church today. Envy, greediness, emulation, and other things. Just yesterday, my friend died in a motor accident. Do you know who sent the accident? His fellow prophet. Pastors, prophets, evangelists, they are now in one union. My brethren, do you know what they are practicing there? Homosexualism, human sacrifice, and the other arranged miracles. I now want to appeal to those fake pastors to amend their ways, to repent from their evil ways, and God will show them mercy. If not, they will go through the same painful experience I had. Thank you, and God bless you.
Having heard this confession, my heart is bleeding. My friend, I don't know what you can give in exchange for your soul. The only thing you should value most is God's word in you and the life you live, so that God will have pleasure in you. I must tell you, there's no gain in all these things you have seen on the surface of the earth that you can compare with eternal life. Let me tell you that Satan is wicked. He wouldn't want you to enjoy God's kingdom. All he wants from you is to pull you out of the way of righteousness, so that you will suffer eternal damnation with him in hell. And so, beloved, stay away from evil and serve God, so that at the end you won't regret it. Thank you for listening to this confession. Thank you, and thank you. Bye.
There is not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not I said one. Nobody. No excuse here. So is it Jesus?
Not my mother.
No, not one.
Not my father.
No, not one.
Jesus, no.
Jesus, no. All about us.
He knows my problem.
He will die till the day.
No,
Jesus, no.
Jesus, no.